Now today we are going to solve another problem on a simple Rankine cycle, but this problem will be a slightly different than the problem which we have solved earlier. So we can go through this problem. In this problem, in a steam turbine, steam at 20 bar 360 degrees Celsius is expanded to 0.08 bar. It enters at a condenser. It then enters the condenser, where it is condensed to saturated liquid. The pump feeds back the water into the boiler. Assume ideal process, find per kg of steam the net work and the cycle efficiency. So key points to be noted here is, we got a P1 is 20 bar and it is expanded to 0.08 bar. Where does the steam expand? Obviously, it expands in the turbine. So the boiler inlet pressure at the steam turbine, that is P1, or the boiler pressure is 20 bar at 360 degrees Celsius. Earlier, if we recall our previous problem, we have seen that it was given 35 bar and saturated. But here it is slightly different. This problem involves, it's not a saturated, but some temperature is given. So whenever there is a pressure and some temperature is given, it might be superheated or it might be saturated. It might be a saturated. So for now, we don't know whether it is superheated or a saturated. So we have to look at the thermodynamics data handbook to find out whether it is superheated or saturated. So we can note it down. This is a P1, pressure P1 in the boiler. Next, this is the condenser pressure, this is P2.08 bar. And also, when its steam expands, it expands till where? Till it gets condensed in a saturated liquid water form. The pump feeds back the water into the boiler. Obviously, it is a Rankine cycle. So, another important point to be noted is, it is a per kg of steam. So, m is equal to 1 kg. And we need to find the network and the cycle efficiency. So we'll solve this problem now. So here we note down the boiler pressure P1 is equal to 20 bar, 360 degrees Celsius, and condenser pressure of P2 is equal to 0.08 bar. So as usual, we can draw a simple Rankine cycle. So that is, this is a Rankine cycle. So we have named it inlet to the turbine as 1, outlet to the turbine, or inlet to the condenser pressure as 2. Then we have it is the lower, that the condenser pressure is 0.08 bar, we name it as P2. Turbine pressure, boiler pressure as 20 bar. Then fluid is being formed from 3 to 4. The fluid is being formed from 3 to 4, that is 4 is the inlet to the boiler pressure. Earlier we knew that the 0.1 lies over the saturated, because in the question it was given saturated. Now the question is, how did we come to know whether the 0.1 is not on saturated, it lies in a superheated region? So how did we come to know it is in a superheated region? To analyze that and to find out whether it lies in a superheated region or it is in saturated region, we use the steam tables. If we go to a superheated steam at various pressures and temperature and look for 20 bar, see here it is a 20 bar. So at a 20 bar and 360 degrees Celsius. So we can see here, this is volume. That's not it right. Here we can see enthalpy. So we have got 320 bar pressure, temperature of 350 degrees Celsius. If 320 bar and 350 degrees Celsius, then that is 3137. And we can note it down that it is superheated, because this is a superheated chart. So otherwise, there is another way. We can see here another, normally a pressure place chart. At 20 bar, the saturated temperature is 312 degrees Celsius. Because you see, our given temperature is 360 degrees Celsius. So 360 degrees Celsius is more than 212 degrees Celsius, because it is more than 360 is more than 212 degrees Celsius. Hence, anything which any temperature which is greater than saturation temperature at a particular pressure of 20 bar, it is considered as superheated. Remember that? So the given temperature should be greater than that of the saturation temperature for a particular pressure. Here it is 20 bar. At 20 bar, 360 is greater than 202. So obviously it is superheated. So we can conclude that our point number one, that is the inlet to the steam turbine, lies in a superheated region. So we can draw here, our point does not lie here, but instead lies in the superheated region. This is obviously a superheated region. So it is a superheated region. This whole thing, anything beyond this line, everything is a superheated region. So because our saturation temperature at 20 bar is less than 360, it is a superheated region. So we can draw a normal layout of the Rankine cycle. So normal layout, everything remains almost same. The only difference is that one does not lie on a curve of saturation curve, but it lies on the in the superheated. How did we come to know? Just like this. Next, what we will do is we will try to find the enthalpy at 1. So we'll go to our thermodynamics data handle. So in a thermodynamic data handbook, we can see here at a 20 bar 350 degrees Celsius and the values are for 400. We don't have 360 in between. So we can see our values lies between 350 and 400 degrees Celsius. That is, the value of enthalpy must be between 3137 and 3247.6. So what should we do in this such a case when we don't have the intermediate values? So obviously we'll go for interpolation. So we will use the interpolation formula. We can see here the interpolation formula. Y is equal to y minus y1 is equal to y2 minus y1, x2 minus x1 into x minus x1. So here the x will be taken as temperatures and the y is taken as the enthalpy value. So we have to find the y1 value. So here we can see, we know at a pressure of, at a temperature of 400 degree, what is the enthalpy. So we look there into the thermodynamic data. So we can look here at in the thermodynamic data handbook at 400, what is the value? 3247.6, and at 350 degrees Celsius is 3137. So we take this as y2. We take it as y. This is y2. This is y1. This is our x2. This is our x1. While what is the y value? We'll go through that. So from thermodynamic data handbook into the formula, we substitute 3247.6313. This is your from 400, this is the enthalpy. 350, this is the enthalpy. Now we need to find what? We need to find the what is the value at y. What is our y? It is the enthalpy at 360 degrees Celsius. Enthalpy at 360 degrees Celsius. So y. We need to find this value. We need to find the value of y. So to find the value of y, we will multiply it by x at a 360 degrees Celsius. At 360 degrees Celsius, that is at x is what? 360. And x1 obviously is 350. Now if you calculate plus y1 is again 3137. So we get the value of y. It is 3159.3 kilojoule per kg. So this is nothing but the enthalpy at H1. This is the enthalpy at H1. Enthalpy at H1. This is the H1 we have found here. H1. So next, similarly, we can find S1 also, that is entropy at S1, by using the interpolation formula. So we have found the H1 value, that is 3135.3 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. You use the same formula on your own and find S1. You will get 6.9917 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So we have found the H1 and S1 at a 0.1. Next, what we will do is calculate the value of H3. So we know where does the H3 lies. H3 lies on a saturated curve. How did we come to know it is a saturated liquid? Because in the question it is given saturated liquid. So the condenser is converting the steam into a saturated liquid. Obviously, where does the 3 lies? It lies on a saturated liquid line. So as it lies on a saturated liquid line, obviously it is H3 is nothing but HF. So in a thermodynamic data handbook, we go to 0.08 bar and calculate, note down the value of HF. We need not use any formula because 3 is completely a saturated liquid. So we can see here in the thermodynamic data handbook at a pressure of 0.08 bar, we can note down HF value because it is completely a saturated liquid. You see, at a 0.08 bar pressure, the enthalpy of the fluid is 173.9. After finding 0.08 bar HF, we can also note down the SF value at 0.08 bar, because 100% it is a liquid, so we can note down the entropy of the fluid, that is 0.95926 kJ per kg. Okay. Next, we will note down at a 0.08 bar what is the value of HFG, SG, VF and SFG. Almost we are noting down all the whole row we are noting down. You can look here, 0.08 bar, we are noting down HF, HFG, HG, SF, SFG, then VF also. So we are noting down almost a complete row of the 0.08 bar. So why? We will come to it. After noting down these values, then our aim is to find, we have found the H1, next aim is to find the H2. To find H2, because where does the 2 lie? It lies under the dome. You can see it lies under this region. So this region is the point where the liquid will not be what? It is neither a pure liquid, neither a pure vapor. It is a mixture of liquid plus vapor. So it has got a dryness fraction. So we need to find the dryness fraction X2. So we can name it as X2 here. So we find the dryness fraction at this point so that we can find the H2, because H2 is not, what is the H2? H2 will be equal to HF plus X2 into HFG, because it is a liquid plus vapor region. So we will find the quality of the steam, that is the X. We know that this 1 to 2 is an isentropic process. Here entropy remains constant. So S1 is equal to S2. So we see here S1 is equal to S2. We have noted down S1. What is the S1 value? S1 is 6.99.17 kJ per kg Kelvin at 20 bar, because 1 lies at a pressure of 20 bar and 360 degrees Celsius. S2 is what? S2 is, it lies in a liquid plus vapor region, so we cannot take it down directly, so we have to find SF at P2. What is P2? 0.08 bar. SFG at P2. What is P2? 0.08 bar. So 0.5926 plus X2 into 7.6361. So we find the value of X2. So we calculate this thing. So we are calculating the value of X2. So what is the use of finding the X2? So to find, what is the use of finding X2 is to find the H2 value. So we will find the H2 value. H2 is equal to HF at P2, which we have noted down here, HF at P2, 173.88. Then HFG at P2, so we have noted down that also, HFG at 2403.1 kJ per kg. Next, we will substitute and calculate the value of H2. So we have found H2, that is 2187.68 kJ per kg. So we are able to find H1, we are able to find H2. So after finding H3 at a P2 pressure, that is H3, because H3 lies in where it is saturated. So at a 0.02 bar, and the pressure is also 0.0 hectare. So at 3, at a point P2 pressure, that is P2 is 0.08 bar, we note down 173.88 kilojoule per kg. Kgs, we have done it. Next, we calculate the pumper. So there are two ways of calculating the pumper, that is HFO minus HF, that is at a pressure P2. Now we can call it as also HF is also HF3. So we use the other alternate one, VF into VF is the volume of the fluid at a pressure P2.08 bar from data input P1 minus P2 into 100. For why we do 100 to convert the bar into kilopascal. So 0.00108 is the volume of the fluid at 0.08 bar into 20 bar minus 0.08 bar into 100, we give it kilojoule per kg. This is the pumper which we have calculated. So next we will move on to calculating the net work. So before calculating the net work, turbine minus pumper, we need to also calculate HF4. So HF4, where does it lie? It lies here. So HF3 we know, we need to find the HF4. So H4, to find the value of H4, we need to use our pump formula. We have found pump work. Here we know the pump work. We need to find the HF4, this value. So to find HF4, what we can do is we can take HF2 on the RHS, 2.008 plus HF2. This is HF at pressure P2. So 2.008 HF at pressure P2, P2 is 0.08 bar, 173.88. So we get this value. So next we will do, what we will do is calculate the turbine work and the net work. That is, net work is turbine work minus pump work. So to calculate the turbine work, we call it as turbine work is equal to H1 minus 2 H2, because H1 minus H2 expansion takes place from 0.1 to 0.2. So we have calculated H1, we have calculated H2, we substitute and find the turbine work. Then what we can do is, next we can we know the pump work 2.008, we know the turbine work, obviously we can calculate easily the net work, W turbine minus W work. Next, finding the net work, this is the answer for the one question. Then another question we need to calculate, that is cycle efficiency, that is Rankine cycle efficiency. So Rankine cycle efficiency is nothing but one of the formula is Rankine cycle is equal to W net by Q1, that is output by input. W net is output, Q1 is the heat supplied. So heat supplied, how can we find heat supplied? Where is the heat supplied in our this cycle? We can look here, H1 minus HF4. What is H1 minus HF4? Just you don't concentrate on this. This fifth value, just to concentrate on 1, 2, 3, 4. Think as if there are only 4 points to avoid confusion. Just we are named H5. So just concentrate on H1 to H4. So heat is being supplied from 4 to 1. You can look 4 to 1 because condenser just pumps the fluid from 3 to 4. And heat is being supplied from 4 to 1. So what will be the, obviously what will be the formula for heat supplied? H1 minus HF4. So HF4 we have calculated 175.89 kilojoule per kg. So H1 is, we already know, 317.89. We get the value of Q1. We directly substitute, we know the W net and we know the Q1. So we get the cycle efficiency of 32.5%. So this is, we have solved this problem. We have calculated the net or we have calculated the cycle efficiency. Because it is a per kg, we are now taking a mass. That is, we are assuming m is equal to 1. That is, for all these values are valid for per kg basis of this network. Everything is per kg basis. So m is equal to 1. Thank you.